a couple of years ago. We got married. Not that we weren't married before, but I don't know why we just did it. We on the day we just paid, I think it was £30 or £40, and there was like an inflatable church. So we went into the inflatable church and it was all full of festival goers in their shorts and wellies, and they were the congregation.
The church organ was brilliant. That was a big ghetto blaster with cardboard tubes sticking out the top of it, like the organ pipes. We did our vows and then we had a meal afterwards.
Somebody painted my face and there was a hairdresser there to, I could have my hair done. It's a different festival than the other ones because there's more to do. There's more activities to do rather than just listen to the music. But my son is a guitarist. I think following Matt around to various gigs, we got into the whole concert and gig scene and festival scene. So this year, as well as the Isle of Wight, we're doing Sonisphere. And there's also the, I think it was the Hard Rock Calling in Clapham Common. I can't walk as far as I used to. If I walk, I can walk okay for the first day. But after, if I do a lot of walking for consecutive days, then my legs start to ache. I mean, you can still die from it if it's not treated. I mean, because mine spread to the lungs, so if it wasn't treated, I wouldn't have made it much past 50. So I've had quite a few extra years, and I'm still feeling okay. I was put on a necklace. I always wear necklaces, and there was a lump about in front of my neck here. So I went to the GP and he referred me to an endocrinologist and he did various tests and I had an ultrasound scan and I was told I had a multinodular goiter and just to leave it alone. And it was only because the lump was getting bigger that I went back and I said I want it taken out. And it was after it was surgically removed that they discovered it was cancerous. I was at stage 4, which was the worst stage you could be at. It spread up to all the lymph nodes in the left side of my neck, so I had to have, after the original thyroidectomy, I then had to have a left neck dissection 2 years later. So I had 2 major operations and 3 radioiodine treatments before I was free of it. But I'm actually not free of it because it had spread to my lungs.
And the reason it's not growing?
Is because I take enough thyroxine to suppress it. Another effect is my dry eyes. I had to have an operation on my left eye because the drainage tube that goes down to the back of the throat, that was all narrowed with the radiation. So every time I went outside in the cold wind, all my eyes watered because there wasn't the drainage tube.
For the tears, wasn't it?
Yeah, the drainage tube was blocked, so I had to have another operation on my eyes. Well, I kept a diary all through my treatment, from diagnosis through to the last operation after that I was in remission. So it was like a therapy, a sort of therapy. So I just wrote every day, and in the end, collated it all into a book and self-published it. So I thought it might help other people that's going through the same thing. The first book I wrote is a physical book through Author House, basically self-published, but the second one, the thyroid, Living with Thyroid Cancer, is an e-book. Yeah, I think I only sell about 10 to 15 books every quarter. I don't sell that many. Because I don't suppose not people haven't got it, so they don't buy it. It's only people that are diagnosed with it that, and I don't suppose there's that many that have been diagnosed. I don't know, because it's rare. You're constantly monitored, and I know my oncologist is at the other end of the email, or computer. If I want to email her, then I can, and she'll answer. So, yeah, I keep quite well, and we eat quite healthily.
I don't eat any. Or drink any dairy, any milk, or I don't eat cheese, again, because of migraines. So I find if I keep off of all those things, I don't get headaches. I'm trying to eat a bit healthier and cut out all the junk, really.
I try and keep my weight down, so I have to do some sort of exercise to stop my weight wanting to go up. For 11 years I used to run, but now my left knee's telling me that he doesn't want to run anymore. Yeah, we go swimming, I do Pilates, try and keep the muscles toned. We go to the festivals, we go to concerts. I go to work. It doesn't stop me doing anything. You have to accept the new normal and carry on, don't you?